The other day, I filmed some footage for you. The topic was meant to be using a limited color palette in your artwork for guaranteed good results. You can be sure when you use a very limited color palette, the outcome will be perfection, no matter what. As I progressed in my artwork, I quickly realized I was making such a monstrosity that even the Sesame Street puppets would find the bright colors too much. I neglected to consider the all-important aspect of proportion. You see, I have this wonderful book on color palettes, which I sometimes use as inspiration to start an art piece. In it, color palettes are grouped by emotion, but generally, I pick a palette randomly as a way to challenge myself out of using my favorite tried and true fallback colors and to get me out of an artistic rut. So I picked a three-color palette out of this wonderful book randomly and started painting. I used three colors, yellow, green, and blue, which you think, oh, those should go together. They're right next to each other on the color wheel. They should go together very beautifully. No, it looked like Sesame Street. It looked ridiculous. And then I realized, oh yeah, when I usually do this, I just choose one or two colors for the background and then use the other colors in the foreground. I could see and feel this isn't working. I was disheartened by my results. My teenage artist daughter asked me, "Did the color palette you used have equal proportions of each color?" She then went on to tell me what apparently everyone who went to elementary school already knows about basic color theory and reading color wheels. "Why did you think there were different amounts of color in each wheel?" she asked me. I hadn't noticed. So, all right, let's get into this. Let's learn a little about color theory. Ooh, I love that. This is the page. Rarely used in isolation, colors are most frequently combined so that the purpose of the color is well defined. Proper proportion is important. A rank order of dominant, subordinate, and accent colors is visually understood and maintains the importance of the main color. Each combination on the following pages is illustrated within a circle that shows the approximate proportion. And so if I turn to the color palette I used for my artwork, which is the kind of tealy blue, the yellow, and the green, so it should have been mostly the blue color, and then the yellow, and with a splash of green. The accent should have been the green. And I did the whole thing pretty much equal proportions of blue, yellow, and green. But it all worked out okay in the end. It all worked out in the end. So that's an important thing to look at if you do want to follow the science of color theory and why color works or doesn't work at creating a mood. Good to know. This story has a happy ending for you and a "so there" to my daughter. I believe you can save any artwork if you use collage, and that's what makes collage so wonderful. You can use paper to cover up parts you don't like, add more colors that you do like, and be pointed in new directions you hadn't even seen before you laid the paper piece down. It looked so awful. I put it away for the last 2 weeks and thought, well, that was a waste of filming a video. I can't show anyone that. And then last night, as I watched some Netflix, I took out my sketchbook at this hideous, brightly colored sketchbook page and took out my Posca pens and started drawing on top of that colorful page. And after a while, it all came together and the outcome of some of the frames are quite nice. So it turns out I was right after all. A limited color palette, if even when you get to that point where you think, ah, my artwork is just awful, if you keep pushing, if you keep layering, you can get to a point where you actually accept that it's good. It's okay, it's good, it's good enough. And you're able to turn the page with some satisfaction. So my end result here is still a lot of each color, but it's so much better than it was. Let me try to fix this piece that I don't like and see if I can turn that into something that I am happy with. Let's see what that does. Yellow. Is the work as good as if I'd stuck to the proportional color palette that the book suggested? Maybe not. But for me, success is when I'm flipping through the pages in my art book and I land on this Oscar the Grouch Grover colored page. It still leaves me with this intoxicating feeling of being finished and being able to easily turn the page and start something new. I will see you next time, I hope. Bye, like and subscribe if you like this video.